Indigenous Comic and Arts Festival that got its roots from the Indigenous Comic Con, but it's basically a comic and arts festival that is focused on providing connection and network and really connecting with what makes all of us Indigenous. So it's a celebration of indigeneity hosted by North American Indigenous people. So oftentimes when people hear the word Indigenous and like Indigenous Comic and Arts Festival, they might assume that it's only for Native American people. But we really look at the word Indigenous as like every human comes from some land, but we are the Indigenous people to North America, which is why we are the hosts of iacon and why we're the focus. I think it's really important because it not only allows, you know, us to really express our fandoms together with our cultures. There's a lot of people that relate to Star Wars and anime and manga and comic books. We have comic artists, illustrators, painters, beadwork artists, fashion, cosplay, special makeup effects, augmented reality, robots, like it's all of the above. All of our vendors are really amazingly talented.
So my name is Sophie Hill and I am here as áyA Creations. I do a beadwork page, I run a beadwork page. And so I'm vending my work for the first time at a fair. This is my first time vending, so I'm also part of the Novice Artist Program. It's a lot of excitement. For me, it's really important because when I was growing up, there weren't a lot of Indigenous cultural gatherings that I had access to. So I knew that I had this this culture to me, and there wasn't really any evidence around me. I lived a very just like plain American life from my perspective, and didn't really get to come to powwows or other cultural gatherings like this until I was an adult. And so now I soak up every opportunity that I can get. I love getting to see things like the opening ceremony with all the dancers and blessing the ofrenda.
I think it's important to boost self-confidence for all the people in this Novice Artist Program along with myself, because I think this is a very great opportunity to feel accepted into like this art community and to have like this opportunity of expression and promotion.
But mainly we wanted to express ourselves through our artwork to show how the different stories, especially with learning of our Navajo and United side, how sometimes they intertwine with each other. So that's kind of like what our designs kind of reflect.
Oh, the community is great here. I felt it was a duty of mine to be at a venue like this, being that I am half Native twice over in my family. I just really felt that people needed the representation and see a professional comic book artist here representing for the culture. So it really feels good about that because I'm not really hung up on stuff like that because I'm like people just having fun, period. And if it ain't fun, there's no reason to even be here, you know?
One of our partners, Vicki Eagle, is actually the Native Artist in Residence at the Denver Art Museum right now. And she organized a res metal concert, so bringing some of the bands from Navajo Nation out to Denver. We finish it all off with the Futurisms Fashion Showcase, which is going to be amazing. We started off with a drag show performance from a bunch of our Two-Spirit community members. And then followed by that is the designers. We have about 8 designers that are all ranging from different styles. And then following the fashion show is a Blacklight Powwow, which is organized by Sarah Ortegon. I'm really excited to see this particular group come together and excited for really a way for us to share our stories and also provide that connection with others who might feel a loss of that connection. So people who may have lost really their own tribal stories from where they came from and their culture, because there's very much the white narrative of the white American is it's just American, but there's all of these other cultures that play into that to create what the American identity is.
Stay elevated by subscribing to the city's YouTube page and stay tuned to our social media channels for more content. Don't miss our new episodes of Elevating Denver, premiering each month. Thanks for watching, Denver.